based upon band theory, okay, semiconductors are divided into two types. One is intrinsic semiconductor, next one is extrinsic semiconductor. Now, what do you mean by intrinsic semiconductor? Intrinsic semiconductor means a semiconductor in its pure form is called as intrinsic semiconductor. Okay, the examples for intrinsic semiconductors are silicon and germanium. Semiconductors in its pure form is this tetravalent atoms. All these tetravalent atoms comes under the example of this intrinsic semiconductors. Okay, now we know that in solid consists of atoms. There'll be interaction. There'll be bonds between each atom. Now, in the case of this intrinsic semiconductor, the bond that exists between each tetravalent atom is covalent bond. Okay. Now, at zero Kelvin, what happens? See, let me draw the band structure of this intrinsic semiconductor. We know that band structure consists of valency band, conduction band, and forbidden energy gap. So, at zero Kelvin, what happens? No free electrons in the at zero Kelvin, what will happen? This entire valency band will be completely filled with electrons, and conduction band will be completely empty. Okay, so this valency band is completely filled with electrons, and this conduction band is completely empty. Then what will happen? There won't be any conduction. Okay, conduction will take place if there are some electrons in the conduction band. Then only conduction will take place. So at zero Kelvin, what happens? Since there are no electrons in the conduction band, so semiconductors at zero Kelvin, that is at lower temperatures, behaves as insulators. Now, when temperature increases, what happens? The electrons in the valency band will absorb some energy and acquire an energy which is equal to energy gap, and then jump into conduction band. Okay. Then what happens? Conduction takes place. Now, let me draw that covalent bond structure in the case of semiconductors. So now, that is intrinsic semiconductor. The example for intrinsic semiconductor is germanium. As I said that in a solid, atoms will be close to each other like this. Now let us see how these atoms are arranged. So this is one germanium atom. This is other germanium atom. Okay, this is other germanium atom. This is other germanium atom. Okay, now germanium atom is tetravalent, means it consists of four valency electrons. This is one valency electron, this is other valency electron, this is other valency electron, this is other valency electron. Like this, each germanium atom has four valency electrons. As I said, the bond formed between these atoms is covalent bond. What happens? A covalent bond will be formed. Covalent bond is formed because of sharing. This germanium atom will share one electron. This germanium atom will share other electron. So a covalent bond will be formed like this. Now, if we take other germanium atom here, there will be one covalent bond here. Similarly, other covalent bond here. Now, like this. Similarly, covalent bond like this. So this is how atomic arrangement looks. So these are the covalent bonds. This is the covalent bond formed with other germanium atom here. Now, so now what happens? For electron to jump from valency band to conduction band, this covalent bond should be break. That's what I'm saying. When temperature increases, what happens? See, at low temperature, semiconductor behaves as insulator, because these this valency band is completely filled, no electron in the conduction band. Now, as temperature increases, what happens? This covalent bond breaks, and electron gains sufficient energy and jump into conduction band. Okay. Now see. Now let me concentrate on valency band. At zero Kelvin, that is at lower temperature, this valency band is filled with electrons. This is one electron, this is other electron, this is other electron, other electron, other electron, other electron. Above this, there is this conduction band. Above this, there is conduction band. Okay, now see, let me draw up to here only. You don't bother about this part. Now, see, what happens? As temperature increases, what happens? This covalent bonds breaks. This energy, these electrons will gain sufficient energy and jump into conduction band like this. Sorry, jumps into conduction band. If this is valency band, this is conduction band. Now, when this electron jumps into this conduction band, the space here is vacant. Okay, that vacant space we'll call it as hole. Okay, now what happens? Again, when hole is created, what will happen? This electron will jump from here. This electron will again gain energy. It jumps here like that. So, because of jumping, there will be a vacant space. That vacant space we'll call it as hole. Now, if you see, here what happens is, conduction is because of holes. See, as electrons move like this, holes will move in this direction. See, take for example, in first case, electron jump from here to here. Then a vacant space is created here, that is hole is created here. After that, what will happen? This electron will jump here and again jump from here to here. Similarly, this electron will jump here, again to here and again to here. So if you observe, electrons are moving in one direction, holes are moving in other direction. That's what I'm saying. So here you can assume two types of currents. One is hole current and other one is electron current. Hole current is nothing but the current because of movement of holes. In electron current is nothing but the current because of movement of holes. Now see, generally what happens? One second, I'll draw this band structure. This is my valency band. This is my conduction band. This valency band is completely filled with electrons. Conduction band is completely empty. Now, by somehow, one electron jumped from valency band to conduction band. Then, here hole is created. Now, what happens? These electrons, because of thermal motion, will jump from one side to other side. So, when electron jumps from one side to other, what happens? Hole will move in opposite direction. But this electron will not get sufficient energy to jump from valency band to conduction band. So, one second, I'm saying, within valency band, because of thermal motion, what happens? These electrons will move from one place to other place. That is, holes will move from one place to other place. But they won't get sufficient energy to jump to conduction band. Now, what happens to this substance? If you apply electric field, what happens? When electric field is created, holes move in the direction of field and electrons move in opposite to it. Means see, what happens? Earlier, electrons moved. That is because of thermal motion, where it couldn't get, it couldn't produce any current. So within this, it is moving, no current. But now, if you apply some potential, what happens? These electrons will jump, these electrons will gain sufficient energy and electrons will jump into conduction band, because of which conduction takes place. That is, current is produced. Now, what happens? When we apply what you call potential to this substance, what happens? Holes will move in one direction, electrons will move in opposite direction. Okay. Now, the point, the thing that we observe here is, current in the case of semiconductor is because of both holes and electrons. Okay, that's what I'm saying. Current is because of both holes and electrons. Now, so in the case of semiconductors, we have two types of currents. One is hole current and other one is electron current. Okay, now see, one, when a hole will be formed, if an electron jumps from valency band to conduction band, one hole will be created when one electron jumps into conduction band. Similarly, if two electrons jumps into conduction band, two holes will be created. Okay, similarly, if three electrons jump into conduction band, three holes will be generated. So we can say like that. That is, the number of electrons is equal to number of holes, or the number of free electrons in the conduction band is equal to number of holes in the valency band. Okay. Now, since number of holes and electrons are equal, then I can say that the current because of electrons, that is electron current, is equal to hole current. Okay, next. Let me say one more point, that is Fermi energy level. What is this Fermi energy level? The highest energy that an electron can have at 0 Kelvin is called as Fermi energy level. Now see, at 0 Kelvin what happens? This valency band is completely filled, conduction band is empty, and this electron has a certain value of energy. That energy will call it as Fermi energy. So what is Fermi energy? It is nothing but the highest energy that an electron in the valency band can have at 0 Kelvin is called as Fermi energy. Corresponding level will called as Fermi energy level. Understand? That Fermi energy level will be in this forbidden energy gap. Now, in the case of what you call intrinsic semiconductor, this Fermi energy level will be in between this forbidden energy gap. Okay. Now, as we know that if you want to increase the conductivity of this semiconductor, what you have to do? You have to go to a process called as doping. What do you mean by doping? Doping is nothing but is the process of adding impurities to a pure semiconductor. Pure semiconductor is nothing but intrinsic semiconductor. Okay. To this pure semiconductor, if you add some impurities, then what happens? Its conductivity will increase. Okay. This process of adding impurities is called as doping. And the impurity that we add is called as doping.